Syracuse.
We'll be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Virginia's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact they can throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
Caught with room to work. He's tackled at the 49-yard line.
Gain of 12 yards.
From their own 49-yard line. First down. Tackle made at the 38. The offense was pretty successful on that play there.
That was a very good passing play to get the ball downfield for a very nice gain and a first down.
Motion. They'll bring him down at about the 21.
Quarterbacks just love this scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
From the 21-yard line, it's first down. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 11.
Get out. 2-7.
He's taken down right around the 8-yard line.
Good for a gain of 6 yards.
It's first and goal. Ball on the 8. Now he tries to buy some time, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 13. And he's immediately tackled. Looks left, finding his tailback.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Check Mike 11.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Just about 3 yards there.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. He gets it up, and the field goal is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Virginia is ready to kick it away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. The stop at the 35.
That makes it first and 10.
And down he goes, the 37-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it to make a catch.
He chucks it downfield. That close to being intercepted.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 47. Tackle at about the 39-yard line. There's a strike complete, and he's taken down at the 33. Got a man complete, and he's hit hard. Complete. He's got space to work. Down at the 21-yard line.
That makes it first and 10. Ready,
check, check.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Throw caught, touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 9-play, 74-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So the score now, 7-3. Syracuse, ready to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Run up the middle. Second and five. Ball on the 30-yard line. Flips it middle to the running back, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. And this one is a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Nice yardage on the run back. This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
There's a play fake. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. From their own 39-yard line, second down. Syracuse holds a 4-point lead. Tackled after decent pickup. Fires out to his wideout.
interception.
We've played one quarter. Syracuse leads 7-3. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Oh, excellent punt. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. The middle for a nice game.
Call it a game of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it, and that's hard to stop.
First down.
Cut it left, cut it left. Four down, four down. Hey, check back 11.
Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Check the outs out there. Four down. Hey, check back 11.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. First down.
Reset, tight right. Hey, check back 11. What's the curl?
Makes it out to about the 39.
Gain of 17 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 39-yard line, first down.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
First down.
Four down. Hey, check back 11.
Scrambling around. He's tackled around the 20-yard line.
That brings up second.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. To pitch it, and now the ball is loose.
Yep, and this is why you need to know where the ball is at all times.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. Made at the 14-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
This is the 10th play of this drive. And he hits him hard at the 1.
That's a gain of 13 on the play.
First and goal from the 1, looking to punch this one in. Defense stacked in tight here. Touchdown, Cavaliers. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. So an 11-play, 79-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lines.
So our score, 10-7. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, The other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
Guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Set! Green 88!
Slings it, and he's hit immediately. He goes downtown. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
How about the quarterback after he threw that football? He's running over to get ready to make the tackle, and the defender drops the football. The quarterback and the offense caught a break there.
And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Virginia is up a field goal.
Sink from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
They go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short. The offense couldn't get anything going that time.
No, they couldn't. They really looked out of sync there, and they're going to have to make some adjustments to come back next time out.
Booming kick. And he's taken down at the 43. Well, we're headed to halftime now, and we're seeing two defenses that don't want to give an inch. Virginia leads it 10-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively. How about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, then a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. You got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later.
Yeah.
We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. They stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Virginia's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
He's taken down at about the 27-yard line.
That's a good game of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Ready!
That's a great tackle at the 22.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
So that sack leaves them a little ways to go here. It's third down and 13. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Number 45 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and 13.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Tackle made at the 32. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Virginia has a three-point lead. He's to the 40. He makes his way to about the 42. First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. To his tight end, nothing doing.
Pass was incomplete. Number 83, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 11.
He scrambled, tries to get around the corner. And down he goes at the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
Four down.
Hey, check Mike 11.
Makes it to the 31.
Call it a game of 16 yards. That makes it first and 10.
He's at the 20. Tackle right around the 16-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
That's right. What's that?
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Hey, check Mike 11. Check Mike 11.
Get up. New 7. Get up.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. And he's taken down at the 3-yard line.
Gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. And they make the stop at the 2. This is the 8th play of this drive. Virginia is up by three. Brought down around the 1 yard line. It's third and goal from the one, and they're trying to make this a two possession ball game. Nice move, and he scores.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he's level at the 28-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 31-yard line.
Stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. First down.
Set, 390.
Quick pass. He's hit and taken down.
That's a deep one. That makes it second and eight.
And he's tackled right away. Quick strike to the receiver.
This defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Here comes the pressure. Ball's completely stopped immediately.
Something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
Yee!
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Virginia holds a field goal lead. On play action, he'll scramble. Loose football, and the ball hawking safety scoops it up. He's tackled at the 37. And that's exactly what this defense was looking for.
Yeah, that fumble gives these guys some added life. Now let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Decent run here, right side. He gets out to about the 22-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Immediately tackled. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. Virginia's got a 3-point lead. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Complete. He's got room to work. Tackle made at the 3. Fumble. They fall on it.
Boy, that nearly cost him. They're very fortunate to get the football back. Late in a game like this, the number one thing is taking care of the football.
They'll be looking for the end zone here. Third and goal from the 9. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. They'll bring him down at about the 3-yard line.
That brings us fourth and goal.
It's up, and it's good.
Big, big kick. It's up to the defense now to make some plays and hold on to this lead.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
Gives it left side, and they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established, and for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. And he hits him hard at the 13. And this one is a beauty.
And down he goes at the 43-yard line. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Ready, left,
left. Tries to set up the screen, but drops. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. Gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
They get this one off and it's a beauty. This punt bounces into the end zone and this will be a touchback. We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down on the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation. He's scrambling. He's out to the 30, and he is drilled at the 36. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 36. Look at his scramble now. He can't get away from the pressure. Just under 2 minutes in the game. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
That's a gain of seven on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
Third and six. Ball on the 40-yard line. The fourth quarter. That could be the turning point. Syracuse is going to use their first time out of the half here. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He's tackled at the 21. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? Get the sack.
That's a loss of 12 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Ready! Green in here.
Check, check!
Eagle! Eagle!
Hot!
So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Let's go, check. Eagle! Eagle!
A tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it.
Tiger!
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. He really got a hold of that one. Brought down at the 44. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. And we're back ready now for overtime. From the 25-yard line, second down. They'll work the left side. Runs outside for a nice gain. The kicker will line up and try to get the first points in this overtime. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good. Complete. He's got space to work. Steps out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
That'll bring up third and four.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackled just outside the goal line. Virginia's team with a tough loss there, but the way their star played today, I think they can maybe build on that for next week.
Yeah, I think that's the thing they've got to focus on. As you said, it's a tough loss for this team, but when you have a great performance by your star player and you're trying to build for the future, they really need to focus on his performance and try to build this team around his abilities to make a play.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.